According to the annual Demographia International Property Affordability Survey, Hong Kong was recently voted the most expensive housing market in the world for the 7th consecutive year. Let's discuss this in detail in today's video. This is Why is Housing in Hong Kong So Expensive? Hong Kong came in at 18.1 in the poll, which divides median property prices by gross yearly median household income. So if someone earns $50,000 in a year, the average cost of a home is $900,000. The 18.1 multiple leaps above the rest in the world's markets. Sydney is the second most expensive city, with a multiple of 12.1, and London and New York, both financial centers, pale in comparison with multiples of 8.5 and 5.9 respectively. So what is it about Hong Kong and its housing that makes it so expensive? So why is Hong Kong real estate so pricey? The most obvious explanation is that Hong Kong is densely crowded, with over 7 million people crammed into a 1,106 square kilometer area. According to government figures, land for residential use made up of only 7% of Hong Kong's total land area, and the rate of land supply and production has slowly increased in recent years. Housing prices in Hong Kong are almost certain to rise due to a lack of supply and high demand for living space. Several cooling measures have been taken by the HKSAR government to control property prices, however, none appear to be effective in slowing down the market. While homeownership remains a pipe dream for the majority of Hong Kong residents, a recent survey by the Chinese University of Hong Kong, CUHK, business school suggests that some people are willing to spend more than the city's already inflated property rates. Costs are rising due to mainland developers. The government controls the majority of the land that can be developed, and it tenders land to developers behind the scenes. The land is selling for record prices, primarily to mainland Chinese developers who are anticipated to charge record high fees for the residences and rental spaces developed. According to the South China Morning Post, two Chinese developers recently paid a record $2.17 billion for a block of residential land, above market assessments by about 50%. Meanwhile, through public housing rents and supported house ownership purchase programs aimed at lower-income families, Hong Kong's government controls nearly half of the entire housing supply. In other words, just approximately half of the housing market is available privately. Land sales and revenue. It's no secret that Hong Kong is one of the world's most tax-friendly economies. One of the reasons the government can maintain taxes so low is that land sales account for a major portion of its earnings. The government can't collect as much cash if property values fall, so there's little motivation to really reduce Hong Kong's housing costs. Indeed, if property prices go too low, the government may be forced to reconsider its tax income scheme. While housing costs in Hong Kong are unlikely to fall anytime soon, according to Demographia, the cost of housing as a multiple of gross annual median income fell from 19 to 18.1 between 2015 and 2016. The study. Professor Maggie Hu, assistant professor of School of Hotel and Tourism Management and Department of Finance at CUHK Business School, conducted a study titled A Tale of Two Cities: The Impact of Cross-Border Migration on Hong Kong's Housing Market, which found that mainland Chinese migrants are willing to pay higher prices than locals when purchasing properties in Hong Kong. Researchers from the National University of Singapore and the University of Cambridge are now working on the project. Due to its close proximity to mainland China, Hong Kong has long been regarded as a migrants' community. Hong Kong has experienced many large waves of cross-border immigration from China over the last two centuries. Because of the paucity of the land, migration has a significant impact on the housing market in Hong Kong, says Professor Hu. The researchers examined Hong Kong property transaction records from 2001 to 2017 to determine the influence of mainland Chinese buyers on the Hong Kong housing market. Due to variances in the spelling of the buyers' and sellers' Chinese names, the data supplied full names of both sellers and buyers, allowing them to determine where the buyers and sellers are from. Mainland Chinese migrants made up 3.67% of all home buyers during that time period. Migrant purchasers, on the other hand, tend to acquire apartments with greater prices and better physical quality than local buyers, according to Professor Hu. When compared to local buyers, they also purchase larger and newer units on higher floors, with more bedrooms, living spaces, and a longer lease term. According to the report, mainland Chinese purchasers pay an average price premium of 4.42%, with considerably greater premiums for flats in central locations and with big floor areas. Furthermore, when selling to mainland Chinese purchasers, home sellers receive 6.6% more money. The future transaction price will increase by 1.7% if the proportion of migrant purchasers in the same building increases by 1%. The safe haven effect. So, why are mainland Chinese buyers willing to pay greater prices in Hong Kong when purchasing a home? It can be explained at the regional, local, and individual levels, according to Professor Hu. At a regional level, purchasers from mainland China are predicted to be more willing and urgent to invest in Hong Kong's housing market when they foresee a lower investment return or a weaker native currency in the near future, says Professor Hu, referring to the safe haven effect. On a neighboring level, it is well established that mainland buyers prefer to live near other mainland Chinese. As a result, they are ready to pay higher housing prices. On a personal level, mainland Chinese buyers frequently have less bargaining power. They also have less market information as newcomers to the city, which can assist them negotiate a better price. According to the report, experienced mainland purchasers who have purchased three or more homes in the past receive a 1.46% discount on their next house purchase. The influx of mainland Chinese buyers appears unstoppable, despite the greater premium. Despite U.S.-China trade tensions and continuous societal turmoil over the controversial extradition law, according to a writer's report citing a recent UBS study, Hong Kong remains the most attractive offshore real estate investment location for mainland Chinese investors. About 12% of the 3,500 respondents said they plan to buy a Hong Kong home in the next 2 years, which is the highest percentage since the study was first conducted in 2015. Many Hong Kong residents believe that the flood of mainland Chinese purchasers has fueled an already hot housing market. However, because these buyers made up less than 4% of all buyers, does this suggest that their purchase had a big impact on the entire housing market? According to the research, the answer is yes. We present fresh evidence that mainland Chinese purchasers in Hong Kong's housing market drive up prices. Even though they make up 3.7% of the total buyer population, the momentum they generate can have a significant impact on the market, Professor Hu notes. Renting a house or apartment. Renting a house or an apartment in Hong Kong is expensive due to the fierce competition for space. This is especially visible in Kowloon, which has the highest population density. A one-bedroom apartment in Hong Kong can cost anywhere between 12,000 and 200,000 HKD, $1,500 to $2,500 US dollars per month. On the plus side, the majority of apartments readily match the highest living requirements. Older structures are frequently refurbished to provide renters with the same level of comfort as new housing projects. Hong Kong is well known for its exorbitant property costs. Due to a scarcity of accessible space and a large population, the Hong Kong housing market is extremely competitive, with high average rent costs. For a modest one-bedroom apartment further away from the center, the minimum rent in Hong Kong is around 15,000 HKD, $1,900 US dollars per month. Expect to pay at least 20,000 to 30,000 HKD, $2,550 to $3,850 US dollars per month or more if you want to live closer to the center or rent a larger place with more amenities. What is the best way to find an apartment in Hong Kong? When renting, you can normally select between a conventional or a serviced apartment, equipped with utilities and other amenities such as a gym, with the latter being slightly more expensive. The majority of standard apartments are either unfurnished or partially furnished. 1 month's rent is usually required as a deposit. Online. If you decide to rent in Hong Kong, you can begin your search by looking online or in the classified section of a local newspaper. You'll be able to deal directly with the owner this way. Agent for real estate. Hiring a professional real estate agent is another alternative. If you're a foreigner renting in Hong Kong and do not speak Chinese or Cantonese, this will most likely be the preferable option. Make sure you and your real estate agent are on the same page about your preferences and your needs, as well as the agent's commission and payment schedule.